automatically had to be carrying automatic sprains, sporadic and accurate. Clips to the back of it, barrel cocking immaculate. Learn to move packages in and out of Los Angeles. We savages, busting off rounds, spraying banana clips, knocking pounds off them like Anna Nicole Smith. Shit, I'm in the hood, walking with choppers, cocking and popping the coppers. Glocks be talking like blockity block blocker. I probably pop.
Is this the mag?
What the hell is you doing?
Camel toe. Homo. Best stuff in the business, man.
What you need that for?
Get you back on your feet.
Yeah, I've been kind of feeling kind of tight in my arm.
Really? With the glove holding you down? Yeah, I think that's the weight of the glove, man. This damn thing is about 2 tons, man. So hold on, I'm almost done.
Man, the FCC gonna get you, man.
Help the FCC.
Anyway, this is the Bag and Cash Football Focus, where the focus is 108-yard kickoff return for a touchdown that turned the lights out.
Yeah, right.
The focus is football and all kind of other stuff. Obviously, this is last show, season finale. End off going on hiatus for a couple of months.
Yeah.
But like I said, I've been saying this all season. NFL, the best sport.
It is.
They put the best matchups. Okay? They put the best matchups out there. Like I said, a lot of people thought the Super Bowl was bleak when it was 28-6.
Mm-hmm.
And my mom thought it. I know you didn't think it because you didn't say nothing.
No, I didn't say nothing.
Yeah, but my mom thought it. She said, oh, it's over. She was, she got all happy, because, we got blood relatives out there, mm-hmm. In Baltimore.
And homies.
Yeah.
And homegirls.
Yeah. And I said, don't be surprised if they come back.
Yeah,
I said that right before halftime.
The game ain't over yet, mama. The game ain't over yet.
I mean, I just knowing that, and that's why it gives me more respect for the 49ers.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, they fought back hard. The lights went out, and everything.
Yeah.
But they played their game. Hey. I think the lights went into their favor.
But see, that's the thing, though. If the 49ers would have won, what type of conversation would we be having? I know my Facebook page would probably be getting lit up.
Yeah.
You know, man, what's wrong with y'all Superdome?
Yeah. I mean, he probably still, but I mean, I don't know.
I don't like it because, see, now we have no more leverage.
Yeah.
All the leverage is going to Roger Goodell.
It goes to Roger Goodell, but I think the fans, and I think the fans and the teams, even though they can say what they want, the Atlanta, whatever, whoever goes there.
Right.
The media loves New Orleans.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Like, every media outlet that, ESPN, NFL Network, all of them said New Orleans been great all week.
Well, that's what I'm saying. We know how to host events.
Right.
But, and the thing is, the reason why, and be honest, before Hurricane Katrina, New Orleans Superdome was the number one place
to have them. They've had the most Super Bowls.
Because everything is within walking distance of the Superdome.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You go to Miami, man, you got to catch cabs here. You got to go everywhere else, But you go just come to the Superdome, everything is right there.
Right, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm not going to say it's a pretty city because know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm getting at.
Mm-hmm.
But like I said, I think the areas that they were in.
Mm-hmm.
Was nice. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I'm sure it wasn't crime written or whatever. I don't know. But like I said, it was a good game. And you're right, it might hurt us in the long run, but I mean, we'll see what happens. Yeah, but I mean, that's one thing they love the city.
Yeah.
They love the city. I think, the lights out might be a minor thing. They'll probably get down to the bottom of it.
Right.
And then, everything will be fine. But
right.
Like I said, we both picked the Ravens. We want to send a congrats to the Ravens.
Mm-hmm.
I got my jersey hanging up. I don't want to get up and show you guys, but like I said, we have strong ties. I watched the parade yesterday. It was good seeing Baltimore.
You
know what I'm saying? It was good, real good seeing Baltimore.
Downtown.
But what we want to talk about this week is the Hall of Fame class of 2013.
Mm-hmm.
All right?
Mm-hmm.
Which includes Warren Sapp, Bill Parcells,
mm-hmm.
Chris Carter,
mm-hmm.
Jonathan Ogden,
mm-hmm.
Larry Allen,
mm-hmm.
Curly Cope,
mm-hmm.
and Dave Robinson.
Okay.
Well, which I didn't know who the hell those two guys were,
mm-hmm.
but I seen that they were black. So I was happy with that.
Right, exactly.
I was happy with that. But you and the notables that didn't make it, that I was kind of surprised. I was happy that Chris Carter made it.
Yeah, me too.
The notables that didn't make it is going to shock you. Jerome Bettis.
Really?
Yeah, which is, he's in the top five in rushing. Like, all time. All time. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Jerome Bettis. Charles Haley still ain't made it.
What?
Yeah, Charles Haley, I don't know what's holding him back. Damn. Andre Reed.
Yeah, I was kind of upset about that. Yeah, I was kind of upset about
Michael
that.
Michael Strahan.
Yeah, well, yeah, I was kind of surprised about that.
I see. I thought either him or Sapp was gonna get in. I thought they both were gonna get in together, but it is what it is.
Yeah.
Anees Williams.
Really, Anees ain't get in yet?
Well, I think this might be his first year eligible.
Really?
Yeah.
That's impossible, man. He retired back in the early 2000s.
Okay. Well, yeah.
He retired like I think after when the Rams. Cause he went from Arizona to St. Louis.
Right. Yeah. Actually, he went to when they played the Patriots.
Yeah.
Super Bowl, he was
I think he retired a couple years after that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Dang, he didn't get in yet. Well.
Yeah.
He was a good shit.
He was. Oh, he was one of the last of the dying breed.
And he's from Fulshay.
Yeah. Tim Brown.
Yeah, I'm surprised he didn't.
Tim Brown didn't get in yet. And last but not least, your boy Kevin Green. Pittsburgh.
Yeah, I'm surprised he didn't get in either. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I'm surprised he didn't get in either.
Yeah, so, like I said, that's your list. Like I said, I think it's the fifth. Cousin been saying it's the 50th year of the Hall of Fame. So, like I said, we'll see if we can make it. If we do go, we will shoot a show there.
We will shoot a show there.
You know?
Yes.
But we'll talk about the NFL Honors.
Okay.
NFL Honors. It was a good show. Alec Baldwin said it. See, he did his thing. Only thing that disappointed me, and I told you about this, and like I said, we'll get down to it, that Drew Brees wasn't up for offensive player of the year. I'm not tripping on him not being up for the MVP, but for him not being up for the MVP, I mean, for the offensive player, was kind of, it kind of bothered me a little bit.
Yeah, I can understand. Because, I mean, you know, first quarterback to ever throw for 5,000 yards.
In consecutive seasons. He led the league in touchdown passes.
Yeah. I mean, same guy who re-broke Dan Marino. He broke Dan Marino's record twice.
Right.
You know, and like I said, he can't even get a consideration.
Right. And the people they had up there was Aaron Rodgers, Tom Brady, Peyton Manning, Calvin Johnson.
Well, I'm starting to look at a lot of these awards like it's a popularity contest versus, you know, a man's body of work. You know what I'm saying? And to me, like I said, hey, you know, we talked about this last show about my son played football.
Yeah.
I'm going to be honest with you. You call me a salt, sap, whatever. But, like, talking about the Heisman, let's speak on the Heisman first. Mm-hmm. You know, if my son is out for the Heisman, I would tell him he's playing defense, I'd tell him not to go.
Right, yeah.
I would tell him not to go. It don't even make no sense to go. Right. Just like, I mean, even with the draft. I wouldn't even let my son go to the combine. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Judge that man off his body of work. Right. Don't judge only what guy.
Because a combine can hurt you.
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. I wouldn't even tell him to go to the combine. If you want to see me, okay, see me at a work pro day workout or look at my film.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's true. That's a good point. Yeah. But you're right. And I said it's sorry to hear, but you know, it's what it is.
That's what I'm saying. I think the year that Drew Brees should have won it was the year that Aaron Rodgers won it. I think Drew Brees should have at least two MVP awards.
Right, the year they won the Super Bowl.
Yeah. And the year last year he broke the record for.
Well, I figured he wasn't gonna get it last year because of obviously Aaron Rodgers' record. He went 15-1. Then he broke the rating record, like the highest rating. And I think he might have had the highest rating this year. I think he had his rating was high. Right. But I don't understand. See, my thing is, I don't understand why they put Tom Brady in it. The only thing that they showed, because they showed a little stat on why they were up for it. And they had, that's why I said Aaron Rodgers, he was the number one rated passer. Mm-hmm. Tom Brady was in it because he threw a touchdown pass in every game.
So did you? Well,
he missed that one game. That's the only game he didn't throw a touchdown pass in was that one game. So I think Peyton Manning because...
Peyton Manning.
Yeah. And Adrian Peterson, obviously, he won it.
Well,
I'm going to get to that. I'm going to get to one. Rookie of the Year went to Robert Griffin III.
That's surprising.
That is surprising because I thought it was going to go to Russell Wilson.
I thought it was going to go to Andrew Luck.
Yeah, see, we all over the place with that. Mm-hmm. Defensive Rookie of the Year went to Luke Kuechly.
But I still think they should have split it.
The
Rookie of the Year.
Rookie of the Year. Yeah, I think 3-3 rating.
Well, no, two ways.
Two ways. Luck and
one, somebody in the AFC and somebody. Oh, that's right. All three of them in the NFC, huh?
No, Luck is in the AFC.
Yeah, excuse me. Yeah, Luck and Luck and RG3, the number one and number two picks.
Yeah.
You know, I think they should. I honestly think they should have split it. You know.
Of course.
So, but. And quit next.
Coach of the year with the Bruce Arians. Defensive player of the year, J.J. Watt. Offensive player of the year, Adrian Peterson.
And MVP.
And MVP went to Adrian. And the comeback player of the year went to Peyton Manning.
Of course. Of course.
So, that, in a nutshell, that's the award. Like I said, it was a good show.
But see, hey, you know what? And this that should serve as fire in the belly of the New Orleans Saints. I've been waiting for them to turn it on for the past 2-3 years. Mm-hmm. And it seems like they get to a point, then they'll pull scale back. You know, then they step on the gas and then scale back. Ever since the year we won the Super Bowl, mm-hmm. I ain't gonna lie to you. That's why I couldn't be a coach in the NFL. I'll be trying to score 50 points on everybody. You know what I'm saying? You know, courtesy rule be damned. I could care less about it. Right. You know what I'm saying? Because until we start blowing teams out, beating teams, mm-hmm. I mean really, really beating teams with submission, we're never gonna get no respect.
Yeah.
But then they're gonna be calling us like, you know, we stat padders and stuff like that, blah, blah, blah. And, you know, finding something else to talk about, finding something else to say about it. You know, yeah. But like I said, man, this league only respects the winners.
That's it. You know? That's it. And you're right. And it's very aggravating.
It is.
It's very aggravating that they don't get the respect. I mean, even Merrill Hodge, who I don't give two shits about,
mm-hmm.
he don't even have, after the Super Bowl, he put Joe Flacco in his top five quarterbacks in the league
mm-hmm.
and don't have Drew Brees or Peyton Manning.
Well, see, and you know what, though? I can understand about Peyton Manning because, I mean, look at his record in the playoffs.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know? See, and everybody calls Peyton Manning elite.
Right, right. And see, that's another thing. I'm glad you said that because I was listening on the radio and they were saying that, you know, me and you talked about this. They have to scale that elite word down. You know what I'm saying? Because who are you considering elite? You know what I'm saying? Like, all right, me and you talk about that. If you want to go elite, you got to say Ben Roethlisberger, Tom Brady, Eli Manning.
Because they have
multiple Super Bowls. Yeah. Now, the only reason why I would put Drew Brees in there, not only because he's my favorite quarterback and my favorite player, is because he's broken records.
Yeah.
You know, his name is in the record book.
Yeah.
And you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
and he's been consistent.
He's been consistent.
He's been consistent. They're not now they're gonna throw out that Joe Flacco, since he has a ring, is elite. I personally like Flacco, but mm-hmm. I don't think he's elite yet. You know what I'm saying? You have to do good in the postseason. And another thing that I heard Monday, they putting Flacco as elite because one guy, Kriegel or whatever on NFL AM was saying, well, yeah, just a minute, he's tied with wins with Peyton Manning. In the playoffs, just as many wins as Drew Brees and Aaron Rodgers and such and such and such.
Mm-hmm.
So you trying to say Joe Flacco is better than Aaron Rodgers and Drew Brees and Peyton Manning? Is that what they saying?
That's what it sounds like to me.
You know what I'm saying? So I that's what I don't get. See, these networks fall so in love with the stats.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And they don't look at the body of work.
Right.
If you look at Drew Brees' bodies of work.
Mm-hmm.
And you look at Joe Flacco's body of work, and you look at Matt Ryan's body of work, Jay Cutler, you can name them.
Mm-hmm.
Not many of them is going to compare to Drew Brees.
No. No. Mm-mm. I mean, Drew Brees has been consistent number one and number two in a lot of the core passing categories of a quarterback. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly, yeah.
And I'm going to be honest with you, if the Saints had a better running game, you know, it wouldn't be that way. But the Saints rely on Drew Brees. The Saints go as Drew Brees go.
Yeah.
Unfortunately.
Yeah.
You know, I would like to see a change in that. Because me personally, I think that Drew Brees as a quarterback has done everything you could possibly do as a quarterback. He's won Super Bowl.
Mm-hmm.
He's broken the passing record.
Mm-hmm.
Touchdowns.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Completion. I mean, everyone you named.
Yeah. He's been in the top.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
You know, only other thing for him to do is win another Super Bowl. It's the only other thing that is left for him to do is win another Super Bowl. Oh, a matter of fact, win two more. You know what? Give him one more and have him win the MVP, then I'd be satisfied.
I mean, he could retire.
Yeah.
He could retire. Yeah. But see, you know what? Instead of calling him for elite, we have to redefine the tiers.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Tier 1, Tier 2, Tier 3.
Now, Tier 1, who's in your Tier 1?
Unfortunately, Tier 1, Brady, mm-hmm. Roethlisberger, mm-hmm. Eli Manning.
Okay.
Because they got multiple Super Bowls.
Right, yeah.
Tier 2, Peyton Manning, mm-hmm. Drew Brees, Aaron Rodgers.
Okay.
Joe Flacco. Oh, they got one ring.
Yeah, fair enough.
You know what I'm saying? They got one ring.
Yeah.
Tier 3. Guys that haven't won a Super Bowl yet.
Yeah, Matt Ryan.
Jay Cutler, Matt Schaub.
Yeah, you got to throw Andrew Luck and all
your yeah. But you can actually throw them in a Tier 4. You know what I'm saying?
Tier 4, okay.
Tier 4, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, because you don't know what they're going to do.
Right, exactly. You know what I'm saying? You don't start getting graded under tiers until maybe you get there, maybe 2 or 3 years in the league.
Yeah.
This next year, I'm going to be looking at Cam Newton.
Yeah.
And put him in a tier.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
To see about that time, year 3.
Yeah, year 3. So that's what they need to start. That's what they really need to start. How they need to start defining the quarterbacks. You know what I'm saying? You become a tier 1 when you've won multiple Super Bowls.
Yeah, I agree.
You know what I'm saying? You've won multiple Super Bowls. Tier 2, still not bad.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Still not bad.
You can call yourself a champion.
You're a champion.
But see, the thing is, though, if you throw another elite word out, so is Trent Dilfer elite?
No.
Brad Johnson?
No.
See what I'm saying? Those they won quarter Super Bowls too. Do you think Phil Simms was elite when he played?
Well, he won 2. But I don't really.
Okay, Jeff Hostetler.
Well,
Mark Griffin. Okay, I'll give you a good one. Steve Young. He only won 1 Super Bowl as a starter.
True. But he ran into them cocaine cowboys.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. I understand that, but mm-hmm. See, that's what I'm saying. You know, you're right though. You gotta watch how, you know, you know what I'm saying? Cause see, the thing is, Steve Young. I'm gonna say this, then we're gonna end off the show. Steve Young, the only record he has is the Raven record.
Yeah, that's it.
You know what I'm saying?
So he's a Hall of Famer.
He's a Hall of Famer. First ballot Hall of Famer. He went in his first year. So that's what you got to look at when you look at that's why I compare my favorite quarterback to, which is Drew Brees. I compare him to, okay, what records can you say that you have? You know what I'm saying? Joe Montana, first bet. Joe Montana didn't like the season on fire. You know what I'm saying? Regular season.
He was overly consistent.
He was.
Overly consistent.
Overly consistent, and he was good in the playoffs.
Good in the playoffs and made the right throws when needed to be.
Right. So, like I said, well, I said that to say this, and like I said, this will be the end. You know, you ain't going to see our beautiful mugs for a couple next couple of months. But, like I said, we just try to figure out, like, you know, where our favorite players fit in. You know what I'm saying? Like, Drew Brees has the passing record. He has the consecutive games record. He has the most complete. I'd be recording this for like 10 more minutes if I run down the record.
Only quarterback to throw for 4,500 yards.
In consecutive seasons. Only person to throw for consecutive 5,000 yard seasons.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he led the league in touchdown passes 2 straight years.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, come on, man. I mean, it's just, you know, I mean, like I said, all true Saints fans know. You know what I'm saying? What Drew Brees means to the Saints and what he means. But like I said, we just, me and my big brother right here, we just want him to have the respect.
Yeah, that's it. Because that seems like he's just not getting it.
Right.
Now, maybe it's because we're in a small market. Okay, that's fine. You know, but at the same time, that's not our fault.
It's not our fault, man. You know? I mean, he went there and he rejuvenated the city.
Right. If our market is so small, why come we got to host in the most Super Bowls if our market is so small? You know what I'm saying?
I don't know.
Does that make any sense to you?
It doesn't make no sense at all, but that's a good point. But anyway, that's our show for the year.
Yeah.
Like I said, we probably pop up every now and then and have a couple of shows.
Yeah, give you a little quick little update.
Quick little update. You know, like I said, we didn't go over the Saints draft, but in April we're around.
Yeah.
And we can talk about that.
Yeah.
And only last thing, the Saints supposedly signed Rob Ryan as D coordinator. I think they're looking at other people, but I think that's a good hire.
I really do.
Yeah.
Me myself personally, because he comes from the same system Greg Williams came from.
Yeah, basically, yeah.
You know,
and then he wants the system that Sean Payton wants to run
is a 3-4.
And that's the system that Rob Ryan.
Funny thing is, That's the same system that I busted our ass against Cleveland. You remember?
Yeah. So, I remember. All too well. But like I said, you know, that's stuff we'll talk about in April.
Yeah.
But like I said, y'all be safe.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Be safe out there. Like I said, we going. I know personally, I'm going into depression mode because there's no more football.
You know? I'm going into hibernation mode.
Hibernation mode. So we gotta look forward to basketball. Yeah. But like I said, y'all be safe.
Yeah.
You know, we love y'all. We'll see y'all in the next couple of months.
Yeah.
No doubt. Peace out. Peace and love.